ओके पीपल, वी आर हियर टू डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक दैट इज प्रेजेंट ऑन स्क्रीन राइट नाउ. द वे दिस सेशन शुड गो डाउन, जस्ट सेटिंग डाउन द ग्राउंड रूल्स. डोंट अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ आउट ऑफ टर्न. इफ यू हैव अ क्वेश्चन, इफ यू हैव समथिंग टू आस्क, कीप दैट रेडी. एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन देयर इज गोइंग टू बी डेडिकेटेड क्यू एंड ए, देयर इज गोइंग टू बी डेडिकेटेड क्यू एंड ए कॉन्वर्सेशन हैपनिंग. सो एट दैट टाइम व्हाटएवर क्वेश्चंस यू हैव अबाउट द थिंग्स दैट आई एम आस्किंग हियर, I will address them then. This is a short presentation, like everything. This is a very, very short presentation. But beech mein, please don't randomly go off on a different tangent and start talking of different things. Keep to the topic at hand. Okay. First is how to develop a mock schedule for CAT 2024. Now see, and when I say mock schedule for CAT 2024, I mean all the exams in this cycle. There are going to be lots of, there is a lot of popular wisdom pervading on different platforms, on Telegram, on Facebook, on YouTube, on different places. Everyone claims to know the importance of mocks. And let's put it this way. Have you heard of Dante, the writer? Dante, there is an author by the name of Dante. And he had written his seminal work is Homer. And Homer happens to be something that everyone has heard of, but nobody really understands it appropriately. And that is the fate I think mocks have gone down of. Everyone knows mocks are important. Mocks need to be taken. Mocks need to be analyzed. But there is a lot of unnecessary drama around how many mocks to take and what should be done after a mock, how to do analysis. For some reason, people have misunderstood analysis as numeric data crunching of what has happened in a mock. See, after a cricket match, if you're looking at data, it is wonderful. If you're looking at data, you can potentially identify trends. But then, if after analyzing those trends, there is no subsequent action from your end, let's say there are balls outside the off stump that you tend to nick because you're driving away from the body, you're leaving space between your foot and your bat, and the ball gets, and then you get bowled quite often, or you're unable to read the variations that the bowler is giving you. If you identify these weaknesses and you work upon them in the nets, then that analysis is valid. If you only see, okay, in arithmetic, I'm getting good score, or on full tosses, I'm able to hit sixes, that is not analysis at all. Those are simple observations. Analysis inherently has an aspect of subsequent action. So how should your mock schedule get developed so that you have time for analysis, so that you have subsequent work inbuilt into your system, and hopefully you are fairly well prepared by the time CAT rolls around. Let's start my introduction. I have teaching experience of more than 13 years. I'm a mentor at Anesthesia Academy and I'm a commerce graduate. These are the three things you need to know. Beyond that, nothing else is relevant or important for this session. Let's go. How many mocks and sectional tests to attempt? The first part is, of course, how many? Then, when to start? What are the minimum thresholds that you should be hitting before you start taking your mocks? Sectionals within them have a specific purpose. Mocks are test-day simulation. Because you have all the three sections, they come in the same order. You have to manage your time, your stamina, your effort, your decision making. All of that comes into play. But sectionals are smaller tests. They are not full length tests. So what is the purpose of sectionals? That I will talk of. And finally, analysis timeline. Analysis timeline, there are two aspects to this. One, what all steps should be done after a mock taking? More generic overview. And then also greater emphasis into how should you be completing the analysis before you move on to the next test or next section or whatever you are attempting. Okay. How many mock sectionals to attempt? See, the general advice is the more the better. But there are caveats. And the first caveat is, there are caveats. The first caveat is mocking, nahi, let's call it testing without analysis is useless. If you're simply taking tests one after the other without necessarily engaging with what the test taught you, what are the areas that you need to work upon, what is the extra effort you need to put in to certain sections. That is absolutely useless. That is you spending time on something that does not really give you any returns. And the second part is analysis. It happens soon. As early as possible. So there are two kinds of tests that you would have on your platforms. In one sort of test, there is a window. You attempt a test and then let's say 2-3 days after the window gets over, only then is the analysis available. Or the other sort of test is when you take the test, immediately after the test, the analysis is available. So depending on the type of test it is, if it is the window-based test, right after the window is over, get your analysis. Or if it is a test in which the analysis is instantly available, do it there and then. Ideally, by the time your CAD rolls around, you must have done at least 7 to 10 mocks of instant analysis. Why this is important is you would have perhaps realized by the time the quant section starts, we live in the day and age of very short attention spans. And because of that, by the time the quant section starts, we are usually tired, we are usually fatigued, and we end up making a lot of careless errors. So for these 7 to 10, or if you can add more numbers to it, even better, do instant analysis right after the test is over. Sit down at least for 2 sections out of the 3, VAR, CDILR, quant, engage in the analysis so that your sitting time in one go is close to 7-8 hours, depending upon your proficiency. Somebody who is very smart can perhaps do it in 5 hours, but somebody who is learning, is on the uptick right now, is not necessarily entirely sure of what all skills need to be built up, or there are a lot of things left for that person to learn. That person will take closer to 7-8 hours. So if you sit down for 7-8 hours, the good thing would be that whenever you're attempting a test for 2 hours, once you build up your stamina for 7 to 8 hours of dedicated, focused solving and paying attention and engaging with the test in front of you, within the 2 hours, you're never going to feel fatigued. And this is something I had developed and practiced and experimented and successfully saw the result of, based out of my experience in athletics. I know I don't look like let's say sports person right now, but back in my school days, I used to be a runner. So I used to specialize in 400 meter running. So jo bhi event karate the. So our coach, because we were 400 meter runners, he made sure that we were running at least 4 kilometers every day. And in that final stretch of 4 kilometers, 10 laps of the field, in that final stretch of 4 kilometers, the last lap was the 400 meter race that we engaged in practice on. The first 9 laps were simply maintaining pace, maintaining pace, maintaining pace. The last lap was the one where we were actually getting our time measured. What this enabled us to do is, if we were only running 400 meter races, during that final stretch of that 400 meter race, of course, we are going to get fatigued, our performance levels will dip. But if we are accustomed to running for 4,000 meters or 4 kilometers, if we are accustomed to running for 4,000 meters, within the 400 meters race on the actual test day, on the actual day on which we are supposed to perform, I'm definitely not going to feel fatigued. Even at 300 meters or 350 meters, I can give myself that extra kick. I have energy left over. I should be performing better than what I was doing 20 minutes ago or 5 minutes ago, or whatever. I have muddled up the comparison a little bit. My running and my test taking both are coming together, but I hope the idea is clear. And the last caveat is reasonable sources. What I mean by reasonable sources is, see, there are going to be lots of places which are going to offer you tests and mocks and all sorts of wonderful questions for you to practice. While most of them are nice, some of them aren't that great. And it's not like I have to tell you what is great, what isn't great. You will perhaps recognize and identify after going through 2 to 3 tests from a particular location that the testing level that is happening here is not that great. Anywhere where you're not being challenged, let's say you're a reasonably average candidate, and in the quant section, you tend to get around how much? 30 out of 66, 10 net questions correct. That is your average. But in some set of tests, you end up getting upwards of 45. You end up getting upwards of 48. And I'm not saying in a one particular test. There could be an individual test in which the level is drastically lower in the quant section, and in other sections it is higher. Some sort of distribution happens. But if, let's say, five, six tests you've taken and across the board you see that every time you're getting very high scores, then that test is wonderful. Keep them for later. Prior to the CAT day, take those two, three tests, give yourself a confidence boost. But then those tests which don't trump you or which don't stump you, they are not really good tests, because a test is supposed to teach you, a mock is supposed to teach you where your weaknesses are. If it only reinforces everything that you already have strong, that is not really a good test. Okay. Now, that said, based on the average performance of kids across the years and different experiences that they've shared, most 99 plus percentilers, most 99 plus percentilers, a few of them are weird freaks of nature, don't take any mocks, but most of them attempt 30 plus mocks and around 10 plus sectionals or each section. Remember, average as a concept is wonderful when you are looking at the entire population. For individuals, that is not valid. 30 plus mocks and 10 plus sectionals for each sections. The sectional count is never going to be higher than mock, or for at least good candidates, the sectional count is never going to be higher than mock count. And don't think of, if I've taken three sectionals, I've taken one VA sectional, and I've taken one DILR sectional, and I've taken one QA sectional. This is as good as taking one mock. This is absolutely nonsense. Sitting down for 2 hours at a stretch and trying to think in all three different ways versus thinking of each of these three sections separately, the effort, the engagement is entirely different. This is the average number. This is the median number. Some of you may not necessarily have the time for 30 mocks because we are still going through the concept coverage phase. Some of you may have crossed this 30 plus number. That is also wonderful. But remember, if we are not doing the analysis along with it, then mocks is absent. Then taking a mock is a useless exercise. Okay. When should you start testing? I will talk of all three sections in BARC, DILR, and in QA. See, of course, basic coverage needs to be done everywhere. But beyond that, my recommendation is in BARC. You must have done 200 plus RC passages beyond your classships. The stuff that you do as homework, the stuff that you do in your formal educational setup, that is wonderful, absolutely great. But your own individual practice should cross 200 RC passages before you start testing. Similarly, in VA, let's say 100 plus and the 50 plus for the last variant. This is for PJs. This is for odd one out. This is for summary. This is for FIB paragraph. Why the smaller number for FIB paragraph? Because it will be very difficult for you to source questions for FIB paragraph. We, as an industry, have been stumped by FIB paragraph question type appearing in CAT 2022. In not just CAT, it was this question type had never appeared in any exam anywhere. Although the question type is very, very reasonable, it is simple. The number of questions available in the market in the open domain where you will have a lot of FIB paragraph questions, that is very limited. So at least 50 plus. But for these three, there is an abundance of questions. Lots of questions are available on different websites, on different places. So please practice them in great quantity. Now for DILR, see, again, your basic coverage should be done. Your basic coverage should be done. After that, you must have solved at least 200 plus sets. Again, in line with one of the earlier questions, where do we find good quality sets or CAT level sets? See, when you are practicing in the nets or when you are practicing for something, you don't get to decide what sort of ball the bowler bowls. You can end up getting a full toss, you can end up getting a Yorker, you can end up getting a bouncer, any sort of things can come your way. A good batsman would be ready to face everything. Additionally, even in CAT, there are some sets that are easy, there are some sets that are insanely difficult. So if you go ahead and narrow it down to, no, I will only solve tough sets, but it will, let's say, incline you towards doing is, for every set, you will have this mindset. Oh, this set has something difficult. This set is trying to trick me in some way. And you will try to outsmart the question setter instead of simply solving what is in front of you. And that attitude also leads to a lot of downfall. I'm sure you've had this experience yourself as well, wherein the question was very straightforward, but then you thought, the question can't be this simple. I'm sure the question setter was trying to trick me this way. And then you overthink and you end up solving the set in a very, very weird fashion. You end up getting the answers wrong. And then everyone is asking you, how did you get this simple question wrong? It is because you're overthinking. You should ideally not be bifurcating. At the time of practice, you should not be bifurcating. This is a tough, I will only solve tough sets or I will only solve easy sets. Whatever sets come in front of you, go ahead, solve. Now, good sources for this, and for this is previous year mock papers. There are resourceful people among us who can potentially provide you with previous year mock papers. Or, to the best of my knowledge, even Inside IIM has a lot of topic tests. Inside IIM website has a lot of topic tests. Our website has daily tests happening, RC and dirigibles and this and that. So, and I think CRACU also has daily tests of this nature. Those are the only free resources that I remember of. So, these are three resources that I know of where you can get a lot of practice sets, you can get a lot of practice questions. On our website, you have tests happening. On our YouTube channel, you have. There is a daily DILR playlist which has roughly 200 sets. Then there is a Prime Puzzles playlist which has roughly 50 sets. And then the new one is Conundrum Carousel. I think we hit 70 mark there. So I think 320-ish sets there are there as well. And you also have Aptitude Jab channel where lots of good sets are there. You have Elite Split channel. You have Quantifiers. I think Rodha also has a playlist. Rodha channel also has a playlist. Whichever channel you can hit upon, simply go solve lots of sets. All of this needs to be done before you start testing. Again, this is my recommendation. You can, of course, choose to disagree. For QA, there are, see, out of these three sections, QA has the greatest syllabus coverage. In terms of theory that you need to cover, QA has the greatest syllabus coverage. So you also need to. People, please, Priyansh, don't give that information because that is. I will talk of this. Remember, at the end of the session, remind me of this comment. I will talk about this later. QA has the greatest theory coverage. So usually, what would happen at whatever places you are studying, your VARC syllabus coverage would be over very quickly. Your DILR syllabus coverage would be over very quickly. Your QA syllabus coverage will take comparatively more time. So now, in QA, there are five sections. Numbers, arithmetic, geometry, algebra, and fields. First thing, do not be selective. Cover everything. Study basics of everything because everything is important. Secondly, out of these five, you need to complete at least three topics out of five before you start testing. Complete at least three topics. Which three topics? Maybe you do numbers, TNC, and geometry alone. You leave out the usual favorites, arithmetic and algebra, or you complete numbers, arithmetic, and PNC. Geometry and algebra are not done, or you leave out geometry, algebra, PNC, arithmetic, and numbers are left. That doesn't matter. At least three topics should be done. And after you're done with these three topics, you must have practiced outside of class sheet again. I don't know if it should be S or C, but I think it should be C. Verb form is C. Anyway, you must have practiced at least 1500 plus questions from the topics that you've covered before you start testing. Why I have been high thresholds for you before you start testing is very often people start testing before they're ready. And then there are two things happening. Either they start to forgive themselves for making errors in the test because, oh, my practice is not enough right now. No, that shouldn't happen. Or the more common outcome is when you've not practiced a lot, when you've not engaged in independent solving a lot, what would happen in the test is you will get a poor score. And for some reason, our sense of self-worth, this is India, and this is perhaps true for the entire younger generation, our sense of self-worth is attached to the scores that we end up getting. Because our scores become low, either we become demotivated, we stop studying altogether, or we start saying, CAT is not great. I'm thinking of public service exams, and with all the latest rage about Pooja and so many other IAS officers with their fake medical certificates and everything. Maybe UPSC is a good option, but then UPSC would does not UPSC also seems very difficult because the success rate is very low there. Maybe Bank PO is great, maybe SBI. Right now we are entering that phase where on different Telegram groups and Facebook groups and different places, you will find a plethora of people. I am giving up on CAT prep this year. I am selling my test series account. I'm doing this. I'm doing that. It, happily be very, very thankful that such people exist because these people are those people who will definitely appear for the exam. They will not study in the interim. And these are the people who push our percentile up. These are the ones who appear for the test, don't score anything, and push our percentile up. So be very, very thankful to them. In fact, if somebody If you are being extremely mean and if you are being extremely rude to the rest of the world, if you find somebody who is demotivated and thinks CAT is not for them, convince them CAT is not for them. But if it is somebody who you genuinely care for, no, do the reverse. Tell them CAT is easy. There is more than enough time left for CAT skill building. But if at all you find somebody who is on the path of giving up, help them. Help them. Throw them on that path. Make sure. Or at least my recommendation is if you've done all this, if you've done all this, then when you're taking a test, then when you're taking a test, if you get a good score, if you're making silly errors, you would be able to identify your errors better. Of course, there is a session, I think the inside eye person who said he will send you the link of prior sessions. There was a session on how to make repositories. Repositories are especially useful in QA and DILR. QA and DILR, wherein you take a screenshot or whatever image of your test questions that either taught you something or were invoked a new style of thinking that you were previously unfamiliar with. Collect those questions. These are the questions that teach you the most. Let's say, for instance, if I give you a car travels at the rate of 15 meter per second. What will be speed in kilometer per hour? This question teaches you nothing. I'm hoping this question teaches you nothing because conversion from meter per second to kilometer per hour is something that we know. But then, if there is a question on this person leaves at this time, one day he left early, and this happened and that happened. Oh, this new style of thinking or this new question setup I was previously unfamiliar with, it has come to the fore now. Let me keep a photo of it. Let me. So, whenever you're revising, you should be going back only to quality questions. In a collection of your questions for repository, there should be a degree of filtering happening. Only good questions, quality questions that stumped you, they should go into your repository. At that time of revision, it should not be going through simple questions. At the time of practice, whatever comes in front of you, we will solve to the best of our ability. You should only start testing once. Ideally, you should only start testing once you hit these thresholds. Then again, remember, this is my recommendation. There is no scientific reason behind this. This is simply based on my experience of teaching for so many years and basically seeing, see, there are certain smart people who will crack that regardless of what input you give them. But then there are certain average people who require input, and this path is the most likely path of success for the average people. Given I'm guessing most of us would believe we fall in the average range, this is the most likely path of success. Again, the inbuilt constraint is going to be some of us are working, some of us are still in the theory coverage phase, so we will not have time for all this. Because regardless of how, where you are, how much preparation you've done, make sure by the beginning of September, by the beginning of September, make sure you start taking your mocks. No later than beginning of September. There is nothing out of the ordinary here, Kush, in the PPT. If you look at this PPT, Most of the stuff is simply headings. There is nothing out of the ordinary in the PPT. Maybe you should can ask the inside IIM people for the video. That would be more useful. The PPT, I have simply kept it open because I have ideas and I did not have time to prepare a very detailed PPT. Okay. Next thing, sectionals. Now see, mocks are for test day simulation. 2 hours sitting in one go, focusing all of that. A lot of people, funnily enough, in the test-taking evolution, first they cover the theory, then they do a lot of sectionals, then they go to mocks. That should not be the order. After your theory coverage, your next step should be insane practice. And post that, you should go to mocks. And after you've taken, let's say, 10, 12 mocks, after you've taken reasonable number of mocks, 10, 12 mocks, you would then start to identify there are certain patterns. There are certain errors you make of behavior, of not of concept, of behavior. Concept-based errors, you need to do more practice, but behavior-based errors, stuff like I read the first paragraph of the RC and I feel it is difficult and I skip it over. I go over to the next RC right away without looking at the questions. That behavior is wrong. Or when I do a DILR set, I never look at the individual component subpart questions because that is my habit. I only look at the set in entirety. Or even with the DILR sets, if I see a set and I know that I can definitely solve it, even if it takes me time, I start working on it without looking at the other questions. These are behavioral errors that we are making. These are test-taking errors that we are making. In order to redress those behavioral errors, is when sectionals come into force. Your sectional tests are only supposed to be for behavior correction. They are not supposed to be a test day replication. Test day replication only happens with mocks. Sectionals, let's say in quant, you tend to spend a lot of time in the initial few questions. You write down the equation, you write down all the information in a very proper manner. By the time the last questions come, you're rushing through in such a haste that you are unable to attempt those questions in entirety or appropriately, and you miss out on easy questions. Now, sectional is behavior training portion. Of course, there are going to be questions. Maybe those questions teach you something, but sectionals, this is more for behavior training. Sectionals are not test day replications. Behavior training. And therefore, don't start off with sectionals. First, play around with mocks. Once you've taken 10, 12 mocks, you would identify what sort of errors you're making, what sort of patterns you have developed. If those patterns are great, wonderful, you can still take sectionals for random practice. But if there are some errors or there are some things that you want to change in your behavioral patterns, then you jump over to sectionals. Your sectional should not be the stuff that you start off with. And this is the reason why the toppers have just 10 odd sectionals for each section, but 30 mocks. Mocks are the real game. Mocks are the actual replication of what happens on the test day. Sectionals are not a replication of the test day exercise. Please do not think of sectionals. If you're taking a lot of sectionals right now and you're avoiding mocks, that is not a good thing to do because what you're doing is you're training your brain to focus for 40 minutes, not for 2 hours, something that will be required on the test day. Please make sure sectionals only come after you have taken significant number of mocks, 10, 12. Perhaps after 10, 12 mocks, you take 4 or 5 sectionals, then you go back, then you take a few mocks and you see that behavioral pattern has gone. Then after another 10, 12 mocks, you again do a deep dive analysis of what numbers, what pattern, what errors you're making. If there is some other behavioral change that you need to make, then you come back to sectionals. Sectionals are not supposed to be your mock replication or not a test-based simulation. I think I've said this 4 or 5 times now, so I hope it has seeped through your brain. For behavior training, for decision making on the test day, that is where sectionals come into play. Okay. And the analysis timeline. Two things, as previously stated. One, this should happen right after the test as soon as possible. If it is a window-based test, of course, you would have to wait for the window to end and the solutions to be available. Right now, there is SimCat 7 rolling around. So, SimCat 7 window ends tomorrow, Monday. So, solutions will be available from Tuesday. That is the usual pattern. So, on Tuesday itself, or Tuesday evening itself, that is when you should be doing the analysis. Additionally, whenever you're solving a mock, there would be a notebook or a sheet of paper on which you're doing all your work. Please preserve that so that at the time of you doing the analysis, you can go back and see what is the work you did for those questions. And then you're able to identify, oh, I made this silly error, or maybe I could have recorded data in a better fashion. That record maintenance is also necessary right after the test as soon as possible. Then there are the other variations of the mock tests that are available. In time, they are known as SAMCATs. Those are take-home mocks. The SimCATs, they are known as take-home. In CL, there are two kinds of mocks. One is prof mocks and one is CDC. No, Flexi mock and CDC. This year, they are CDC Pro and CDC Flexi. These are the two types. Now, CDC Flexi, even after the window is over, you can take the analysis, would be instantly available. CDC Pro, if you miss, they will only open at a later point of time. So don't miss CDC Pro, but CDC Flexi, perhaps you can wait until the window is over. Even if you don't take it in the window, the only thing you're missing out is on a national percentile, which is not important. Analysis is supposed to be about you, not about the test. It is about me. What could I have done better? What could I have improved? It is not, okay, this question, these many people got right or these many people got wrong. Let's say, for instance, very often I see a lot of people thinking that analysis is how many people got this question right? What was the difficulty level of this question? There have been instances where a particular question that people are saying is difficult, or the return on investment of time on that question is very low for majority population. But for me, it was a sub-1 minute question because there is an insight that I already knew. Of course, for me, it is easy. And I'm sure this is not just for me, this would also happen with you. There are going to be certain setups, there are going to be certain ideas that you are very comfortable with, and you are able to do better than most of the rest of the population. You are going to be better than not everyone, but majority of the population you are better at. So rating of questions, whether it is A type or B type or C type, whether it is a good attempt, it is a bad attempt, risky shot, all those labels, they are fun to see. They have very little value because the rating that matters, the level identification that matters, is the level that you identify of the question for yourself. If I feel the question is easy, or if I feel I should have done it in under this much time, then I should have done it in under this much time. Or if I feel, let's say, there is a question that everybody found easy, everybody found easy. I did not find easy. I spent a lot of time on it. There have also been instances where I see the average time taken by the population who got it right is 1 minute 27 seconds, but I took 3 minutes 38 seconds. That also happens. So now here, again, my task is to identify what is it that I was missing out on, or what is it that I was assuming extra that led me to doing this, all this extra work. Maybe I could have shortened my work. This learning also goes into my repository because this is, of course, an error that I'm making at my end. First is right after the test as soon as possible. Now, the second level work is, see, all this analysis will lead you to create a repository, hopefully. What I mean by repository is collection of all the good questions you've identified in Quant and DILab. Repository for English ERC section makes very little sense because you can't go back to a set, and perhaps you can make a repository for ERC section as well, but DILR in Quant, it helps immensely. Once you've created the repository, it is not just I will only collect these questions. You're supposed to go back to this repository every 2 weeks or every 15 days. Not every 2, 3 days. There must be a significant gap, at least a gap of 2 weeks between you going back to those questions. Now, you will again look at this question. If you are able to solve it, if you are able to identify what needs to be done, and you are doing it in the manner that you expected it to happen in the first iteration, great. Three times, when a question has been seen by you and you are able to identify the inbuilt trap or the inbuilt idea that they were testing you on, then this question gets removed from the repository, and this keeps on happening every 2 weeks, every 15 days. So let's say right now is July 21st, the number of times you go back to the repository, let's say first time you go is end of July. Then it could be mid-August, end of August, mid-September, end September, mid-October, end October, and mid-November, because end November is, of course, the CAT exam itself. These many times you have to go back to this. The idea behind this repository, the idea or the intent behind this repository is, see, in the CAT prep world, let's say this is the list of all the errors that one can make. This is the list of all the errors that one can make. And right now, you are good enough to avoid these many errors. This is your current level. But these sorts of errors or these silly mistakes, you still make. When you add questions to your repository, giving them extra time, giving them extra attention, paying heed to them, essentially what you're doing is, you're expanding this marker is moving rightwards now. By the time CAT rolls around, you must have taken enough mocks, enough tests, that this marker is closer to this point. You're never going to reach the end because nobody is that smart that they will never make a mistake. But the more you can stretch the range of silly errors that you can potentially make, or sorts of comprehension or concept errors that you can make, the more you can push it rightwards, your range of errors should fall down, which is also where I highly talk of. The score that you get in a mock test is absolutely immaterial. What is extremely important is, what sort of errors are you making? If you're making similar sort of errors, if you're making similar sort of errors from one test to the other test, let's say in one mock you've got a score of 74, and in the next mock you've got a score of 98, but the errors you make are very similar to the test errors that you make in the last one, then this was a bad mock. But let's say in one test you got 74, and in the next test you got 62 only. But the errors that you made are of new kind. You have not repeated your earlier errors. The errors that you made are of new kind. Then it was a good mock. Your scores are absolutely immaterial. Your percentile that you get in a test is absolutely immaterial. The focus of the mock test exercise, all these sections, is supposed to be how can you improve, not where you stand in comparison to the rest of the world. You have very little control over where you stand in comparison to the rest of the world. And in any case, if you want to improve your standing with the rest of the world, you have to work on you. You have to identify what mistakes you are making, what sort of errors you are prone to make. And if you can cut down on the errors that you are prone to make, or increase the knowledge base that you currently have, you are getting better with respect to others. That is the most important thing. That is all I had to say with respect to analysis timeline. Everything that I had to say is done. Now is the Q&A section. Whatever questions you have, you can go ahead and ask. One thing, never send a direct message to me, please. Don't send a direct message. Please ask. One minute. Achha, this next section also. If you have a question, raise your hand. I will ask you to unmute. Unmute. We will talk. That is better than sending one, two line things in chat. Although Shashank has sent a very detailed things. Should we practice mixed questions, say, for arithmetic topic-wise before the next one? Somebody, please, if you have a question, please raise your hand. I prefer engaging in direct conversation than chat-based thing, because in chat, the idea gets muddled. Should we practice mixed questions, say, there are two phases of practice. One is right before you start taking mocks. At that time, whether you take it topic wise, you take it mixed. As in, at that time, you will take it topic wise because the topic that you've just finished, that is what you would be practicing on. Later on, once all your topics are done, then mixed practice is the best way to go. Unless you've identified in arithmetic, I tend to get these sorts of questions wrong. The time, speed, distance, time and work questions I get wrong. At that time, you go back and do practice of arithmetic. But when you're prior to mock taking, topic-wise is the best way. Is Excel sheet important to do? Is Excel sheet important mock analysis? This is precisely why I said chat-based questions don't make sense. Excel sheet, I don't know. Some degree of record maintenance is nice, but then going into too much granular details on this topic and this error, as in for algebra in functions in converging series, I made the error of not taking two in the denominator. That level of granularity is not needed and not helpful. Timed practice recommended. Depends on your level. If you're doing better than most, then great. If you're not doing better than most, see, that's different stages of preparation. If you're right at the beginning, timed practice is an irrelevant detail. If you're closer towards the end, timed practice would be recommended. Can I take mocks more frequently, 2 to 3 a week starting from now? If you take 2 to 3 mocks starting from now, after every mock, you have to do analysis. And analysis should take you a good 8 to 10 hours. And that will give you subsequent actions about which topic you need to work up more on, what sort of extra practice you need to engage in. If in a week you can fit in one mock with 8 to 10 hours of analysis with roughly 5 to 6 hours of subsequent work, take 3 mocks, take 5 mocks, who cares? The work is important, not the number of mocks that you take. Where can we get previous year mocks? You would have to be resourceful. There are several places where you can get previous year mocks. I am not the person to get it. Yes, Priyansh. You had talked of last year mocks, no? Previous year CAT papers as a mock test. Is that what you're asking, Priyansh?
नहीं सर, माय क्वेरी वाज रिलेटेड टू वीएआरसी। मतलब थिंग इज कि वीएआरसी में मेरा अच्छा सेक्शन है तो मेरा यूजुअली स्कोर आ जाता है, बट द थिंग इज फ्रॉम एक पिछले मॉक से और सेवरल सेक्शनल्स दैट आई एम गिविंग, वीएआरसी में मतलब बहुत ज्यादा लो स्कोर आ रहा है। आई हैव रिफ्लेक्टेड बैक कि ऐसा भी नहीं है, मतलब परसेंटाइल तो
अच्छा, एक
रिलेटिव
मिनट,
रहे।
दो दो बातें,
हाँ
दो
जी,
बातें। एक, कितने टेस्ट हो गए ऐसे?
सॉरी,
व्हेन यू से मेरा बीएआरसी स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट सेक्शन है, यू
हाँ
केम
जी
टू दिस कंक्लूजन आफ्टर हाउ मेनी टेस्ट और मार्क्स?
सर, वो एक्चुअली मेरा थर्ड अटेम्प्टेड कैट है। लास्ट ईयर भी मेरा 99+ ही आया था, तो फिर
अच्छा
मतलब बेस्ड अपॉन दैट।
अच्छा Still, my question remains. You came to the
हाँ जी,
conclusion, my BARC strong. You came to that conclusion after how many tests and mocks?
सर फॉर कैट 2022 आई गेव 34 मॉक्स। कैट 2023 में मैंने 34 मॉक्स दिए थे। मैंने
अच्छा,
सिक्स्थ मॉक दिया अपना CDC Pro 2, और
ठीक
सेक्शनल मैंने इस साल अभी तक मतलब ऑलमोस्ट 10 तो दिए होंगे बीआरसी के।
है। तो देख, you are answering how many mocks you've taken so far till date. I am asking, when you arrived at this conclusion that VARC is your strongest section, how many mocks or tests did it take you to arrive at that conclusion?
मतलब सर 68+6 74 मॉक्स टिल डेट जो मैंने लिए हैं अभी तक की अपने प्रिपरेशन जर्नी में।
भाई अच्छा, तो रीसेंट मॉक्स में तो गंदा स्कोर नहीं आया अपना?
रीसेंट, हाँ, जो लास्ट का मैंने
तो
एक
भाई, तो
दो
रीसेंट
मॉक
मॉक्स से पहले यू मस्ट हैव अराइव्ड एट दिस कंक्लूजन समवेयर अराउंड दी 30-40 मॉक मार्क, उसी टाइम पे पहुंच गया होगा। बीएआरसी तो अपना सॉर्टेड है, वहां ठीक रहता मामला। ठीक
हाँ मतलब सर पिछले 2 साल से तो सही जा रहा है। अभी भी स्टार्टिंग में क्या,
है,
स्टार्टिंग के मॉक्स
ठीक
में भी
है।
अच्छा था,
दूसरा
चार
दूसरा
मॉक्स
दूसरा दूसरा,
हाँ जी
अभी कितने मॉक खराब हो गए कि अपने ये बोल रहे कि अपना बीएआरसी बिगड़ गया?
सर, 2 मॉक्स और जो आरसीज में प्रैक्टिस कर रहा हूँ उसमें भी एक्यूरेसी जा रही है, सेक्शनल में भी नहीं आ रहा। लास्ट कंसिस्टेंटली 2 मॉक्स 3-4 सेक्शनल हो गए।
कितने टेस्ट? 6 टेस्ट,
हाँ नहीं, हाँ मतलब 5-5 टेस्ट, 5 3+2 5।
5 टेस्ट, ठीक है। इन 5 टेस्ट में, इन 5 टेस्ट के लिए एनालिसिस करी होगी होपफुली,
हाँ जी सर, हाँ
तो उन एनालिसिस में क्या आइडेंटिफाई किया, हमारा क्या एरर हो रहा
जी। तो सर एरर ये हो रहा है कि मतलब जब व्हेन आई वर सिट फॉर एनालिसिस तो मैं पूरा सेक्शनल एक बार दोबारा देता हूँ, चाहे पूरा सेक्शनल 40 मिनट्स में ना दूं, बट आरसी तो अटेम्प्ट करता हूँ कि एक्यूरेसी कहाँ हिट हो रही है, कि अगर सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ। पर सर उस एनालिसिस में भी मेरे वो क्वेश्चंस गलती हो रहे,
भाई? हम तेरे
मतलब
से,
मैं
तू तो ये देख रहे हैं आरसी का, मेरे को स्किल मस्त एक सी समझ में आ रहा है। हम तेरे से आम पूछ रहे, तो मेरे को बार बार इमली 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 जवाब दिए जा रहे हैं। हम पूछ रहे हैं एनालिसिस के दौरान, व्हाट हैव यू आइडेंटिफाइड, व्हाट इज द सॉर्ट ऑफ एरर दैट यू आर मेकिंग? यू आर टेलिंग मी द प्रोसेस ऑफ योर एनालिसिस एंड द आउटकम ऑफ यू गेटिंग क्वेश्चंस रॉन्ग, वो तो सिम्टम है। अभी हम पॉज पूछ रहे हैं, हैव यू आइडेंटिफाइड व्हाई यू आर गेटिंग योर क्वेश्चंस रॉन्ग इन द रीसेंट टेस्ट? व्हाट हैव यू चेंज्ड? मे बी व्हाट इज इट दैट यू आर डूइंग डिफरेंटली राइट नाउ, और व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ एरर्स यू आर मेकिंग? व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ एरर्स, वो बताना।
सेम सर, जो मैं पहले करता था मैं वही अब कर रहा हूँ। ऐसा भी नहीं है कि कोई ऐसे टॉपिक से आरसी आ रहे हैं जो मैंने पहले पर एओन्स में पढ़ा नहीं है, इसीलिए मुझे समझ नहीं आ रहा कि मैं कहाँ गलत जा रहा हूँ। मतलब कुछ आउट ऑफ द ऑर्डिनरी नहीं मैं कर रहा हूँ, जो पहले मैं करता था वही मैं कर रहा हूँ। दैट
अच्छा,
इज वाई, हाँ जी वही दिक्कत आ रही है कि समझ नहीं आ रहा कि गलत कहाँ जा रहा हूँ।
भाई अच्छा एक बात बता, अभी तक बेस्ड ऑन योर क्वेश्चन यू नॉट स्पेंट एनी एनी टाइम टुवर्ड्स आइडेंटिफाइंग तुम गलत कहाँ जा रहे हो। यू आर वेरी इमोशनली चार्ज कि भाई गलत जा रहा हूँ, दुख हो रहा है मेरे को, बट देन देर हैज नॉट बीन अ डिस्कवरी प्रोसेस फॉर हम गलत कर क्या रहे। ये बता, लेट्स से पहले हम जब आरसी पढ़ते थे और अब जब हम आरसी पढ़ते, इज आर रीडिंग स्पीड द सेम, प्रिसाइसली द
हाँ
सेम,
जी
और आर वी अ लिटिल मोर कैवेलियर वाइल रीडिंग राइट नाउ बिकॉज द आइडिया हैज सेटिंग, बिकॉज द आइडिया हैज सेटिंग कि भाई आरसी तो मेरा ठीक हो ही जाता है, चलो हम ऊपर ऊपर से पढ़कर भी काम चला देते हैं। हैज देयर बीन अ शिफ्ट इन रीडिंग स्पीड रिसेंटली? कुड
कुड बी अ रीजन सर।
बी अ रीजन, बट इफ दैट इज द रीजन देन द रिकमेंडेड एक्शन इज नेक्स्ट डिफरेंट, और मे बी द रिसेंट टेस्ट दैट यू टेकिंग, ऑल्दो इट इज अ स्टैटिस्टिकल इम्पॉसिबल मतलब इम्प्रोबेबिलिटी, बट मे बी द रिसेंट टेस्ट दैट यू टेकिंग दीज आर डिफिकल्ट टेस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ विच कंपैरेटिवली यू वुड बी कंपैरेटिवली यू शुड हैव बीन अ लिटिल मोर सर्कमस्पेक्ट इन अटेम्प्टिंग एवरीथिंग। जैसे मेरा भी ये आरसी के अंदर, आई ऑलवेज अटेम्प्ट ऑल क्वेश्चंस, कोई भी टेस्ट हो कहीं भी हो, आई अटेम्प्ट ऑल क्वेश्चंस बिकॉज आई नो इवन व्हेन आई एम अनश्योर 10 में से 7 मेरे सही हो जाते हैं आरसी के अंदर। आरसी के अंदर आई अटेम्प्ट एवरीथिंग, वीए के अंदर आई मे लीव आउट क्वेश्चंस, बट आरसी के अंदर आई अटेम्प्ट एवरीथिंग। नाउ दैट कम्स बैक टू बाइट मी इन सेवरल टेस्ट, क्योंकि वहां पे आरसी बहुत ही ज्यादा फाड़ आई हुई होती है, तो वहां पे मेरा 16 में से 11 ही सही हो रहा है आरसी, तो मेरा स्कोर गिर जाता है। बट वो मेरे को टेस्ट के बाद एनालिसिस के बाद पता चलता है भाई इस आरसी के अंदर थोड़ा लाइट होकर चलना था, सारे सवाल नहीं मारने चाहिए थे। हैव वी इज दैट अ पॉसिबिलिटी?
नो सर, दैट कैनॉट बी अ पॉसिबिलिटी बिकॉज अगेन कि
ठीक है ठीक है ठीक है ठीक
चैलेंज
है, अभी हम बस आई एम गिविंग यू अ चेकलिस्ट, सी वॉट फिट्स एंड देन यू विल बिकॉज ऑफ द कॉज आइडेंटिफिकेशन यू विल बी एबल टू डू दी सब्सिक्वेंट रिड्रेसल। तो ये नहीं है कि भाई आरसी टेस्ट डिफिकल्ट नहीं थे, CDC 2 CDC Pro Mock 2 जो भी था उसका आरसी, ये आरसी सेक्शन अपने लिए डिफिकल्ट नहीं था, या वट एवर अदर टेस्ट वी गिवन वो डिफिकल्ट नहीं था। अच्छा थर्ड ये हो रहा है क्या कि मे बी वी आर स्पेंडिंग, हैव वी स्विच्ड अराउंड आर ऑर्डर ऑफ अटेम्प्टिंग क्वेश्चंस, पहले आरसी बाद में बीए, या पहले बीए बाद में आरसी, इसके अंदर कुछ बदलाव किया है क्या?
हाँ सर। मतलब इनिशियली पहले मैं सबसे पहले पैरा समरी करता था बिकॉज उसे थोड़ा रीडिंग हैबिट और ऑप्शंस एलिमिनेशन की हैबिट में आ जाता हूँ, फिर आरसीज पे जाता था। हाँ दिस कुड बी अ रीजन सर, मैं पहले सीधा आरसी पे जा रहा हूँ।
अच्छा
हाँ ओके okay.
तब चीज, दिस इज व्हाट आई मीन बाय एनालिसिस, यू हैविंग अ बैड स्कोर और यू बीइंग पुट आउट बाय द फैक्ट कि मेरे नंबर ठीक नहीं आ रहे, दैट इज नॉट एनालिसिस एट ऑल। एनालिसिस इज हम बिहेवियर में क्या गड़बड़ कर रहे हैं। सो मे बी योर ब्रेन इज अकस्टम्ड, देयर आर पीपल हु डू बीएआरसी सेक्शन ऐसे कि भाई सीधा आरसी पे जंप करेंगे फिर बीए सेक्शन पे जाएंगे। देयर आर पीपल हु अटेम्प्टेड दिस वे, बीए के 2 सवाल करते हैं फिर आरसी करेंगे, फिर बीए के 2 सवाल करते हैं फिर आरसी करेंगे, बिकॉज टेंस रीडिंग आरसी पैसेजेस डज नॉट वर्क फॉर देम। देन देर आर सर्टन पीपल उसे बीए के 8 सवाल पहले करेंगे फिर ही आरसी करना चालू करेंगे, क्योंकि आरसी के अंदर हाथ अपना तंग है, बीए के अंदर कम से कम कम टाइम में आर या पार की बात हो जाती है। साथ के साथ अगर आरसी पहले अटेम्प्ट करो तो बाई द टाइम यू मार्क द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन यूजली अराउंड 8 मिनट्स हैव पास, एंड दिस टेंड्स टू हैव क्या बताए साइकोलॉजिकल इम्पैक्ट ऑन पीपल। ओ 8 मिनट बीत गए अभी तक एक भी सवाल नहीं किया। इफ आई अटेम्प्ट बीए क्वेश्चंस फर्स्ट देन बाय अराउंड द 10 to 12 मिनट मार्क आई सी 8 क्वेश्चंस आ रही, सो इट गिव्स मी सम सॉर्ट ऑफ पीस। इसके चक्कर में आरसी में भी अगर टाइम लगाते तो बुरा नहीं लगता है। देयर आर पीपल उसे बीए पहले करते फिर आरसी करते, बीए फिर करते आरसी करते, बिकॉज बीए आई नो माय एक्यूरेसी इज नॉट दैट हाई इन बीए, लेकिन यहाँ से मेरा इंजन रेव अप करना चालू कर देता है, दिमाग थोड़ा चलना चालू हो जाता है। सो बाय द टाइम आई कम टू माय आरसी पैसेज, बाय द टाइम आई कम टू माय सॉल्विंग ऑफ आरसी, उस टाइम पे माय ब्रेन इज ऑलरेडी फंक्शनिंग एट अ हाई लेवल, तो हम यहाँ पे ठीक ठाक कर पाते। बट देन व्हाट प्रिसाइसली अप्लाइज टू यू इंडिविजुअली आई वुडंट नो, यू वुड हैव टू सी व्हाट हैज चेंज्ड, व्हाट हैज चेंज्ड एंड इज दैट द चेंज, इज दैट अ कॉजल थिंग, इफ इट इज अ कॉजल थिंग यू नो वॉट टू रिड्रेस, इफ इट इज नॉट अ कॉजल थिंग यू वुड हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द कॉज फॉर द डिक्लाइन। बस दुखी होने से कुछ नहीं होता, मतलब मुझे शुरुआत में था ना अपना, मेरा नंबर गिर गया, मेरा नंबर गिर गया, बिल्कुल तेरा भी दुख है, सबका दुख है, सबको रहता है, उसमें ये सोच कि भाई दिक्कत क्या हुई, इफ यू कैन आइडेंटिफाई दिक्कत क्या हुई, सबसिक्वेंट एक्शन विल बी इजियर टू एग्जीक्यूट।
ठीक है ठीक है ठीक है, थैंक यू।
ओके यस ओमकार।
यस सर, एक्चुअली आई वांटेड टू आस्क रिगार्डिंग द सेक्शनल्स ओनली। बेसिकली मुझे एनालिसिस में ही प्रॉब्लम हो रही है। जैसे मैंने कोई मॉक दे दिया मान लेते, सो लेट से अब क्वान का मुझे एनालिसिस करना है, तो उसमें डिफरेंट डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स, चैप्टर वाइज टॉपिक्स थे। तो उस टॉपिक्स में अब कुछ कुछ क्वेश्चन मैंने सॉल्व किए होंगे, कुछ कुछ नहीं किए होंगे। तो आई शुड हाउ शुड द प्रोसेस ऑफ एनालिसिस बी
अरे
सेम फॉर एलआरडी एंड सेम फॉर
सिंपल आंसर दे रहे, हाउ टू एनालिसिस फॉर ऑल थ्री सेक्शंस, माय ओपिनियन ऑन द इश्यू। हमने मस्त एकदम क्या कहते हो, यूट्यूब पे एक प्लेलिस्ट बनी हुई है, 2019-20 की वीडियो है। अभी तक द प्रोसेस द बिलीफ सिस्टम रिमेन्स प्रिसाइसली द सेम, जाना एक प्लेलिस्ट बनी हुई है, उसके अंदर मॉक एनालिसिस का टेम्पलेट फॉर दोज ऑफ अस हु आर एक्सेल फैंस वो भी दे रखा है, और तीनों सेक्शन हम अटेम्प्ट करते वक्त क्या सोचते हैं और एनालिसिस करते वक्त क्या सोचते हैं, एवरीथिंग इज मेंशन इन इंपॉर्टेंट। देर आर डिफरेंट सॉर्ट्स ऑफ आउटकम्स यू कैन हैव, आइदर इट कैन बी अ कॉन्सेप्ट एरर, अ केयरलेस एरर, कॉन्सेप्ट एरर अबाउट अ थिंग दैट यू ऑलरेडी स्टडीड, कॉन्सेप्ट एरर अबाउट अ थिंग दैट यू नॉट स्टडीड सो फार, मे बी समथिंग न्यू दैट यू लर्न। तो क्या क्या आउटकम्स रह सकते हैं, क्या काम करना चाहिए, ये जाके यूट्यूब पे देख लेना। इट विल सेव यू अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम, इट विल सेव मी अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम। आई कैन मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन देन।
और सर कहाँ पे जाना?
यूट्यूब मेरा यूट्यूब चैनल जानते हैं, एक है
यस
यही
यस
एनेस्थेसिस अकेडमी, यहाँ जो लिखा हुआ आई एम टू लेजी, यहाँ पे एनेस्थेसिस अकेडमी पे जाना। हाउ टू डू एनालिसिस फॉर ऑल थ्री सेक्शन, इफ समबडी कोई अगर जोशीला चैट में लिंक डाल सके तो इवन दैट वुड बी बेटर, लेकिन यूट्यूब पे मिल जाएगा। सेम सिंपल बात है, होपफुली यू विल सी माय एनालिसिस हैज एब्सोल्युटली नो सेक्शन, हैज एब्सोल्युटली नो वेटेज गिवन टू दूसरों का कितना स्कोर आया, मेरा कितना स्कोर आया, इट इज ऑल रिवॉल्विंग अराउंड हम क्या चेंज कर सकते हैं, हम क्या गलती कर रहे हैं। यू डोंट नीड टू गो वेरी ग्रैनुलर, यू नीड टू आइडेंटिफाई योर ओन बिहेवियरल पैटर्न्स।
श्योर सर, थैंक यू। हाँ
ओके जॉर्डन वॉन,
हाय सर, सर एक डाउट था, जैसे जो आपने सेक्शनल्स और फुल लेंथ मॉक्स का बताया था ना, तो आई वाज थिंक मतलब आई वाज गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद सेक्शनल। तो मेरा ये फ्लो ऑफ आइडिया रहने वाला था कि फर्स्ट आई विल अटेम्प्ट लाइक अक्रॉस 10-15 सेक्शनल्स एंड देन आई विल स्विच टू फुल लेंथ मॉक्स। तो सर उसके बजाय फिर मतलब एक क्वेश्चन तो ये था कि अब ऐसा कर सकते हैं कि मतलब जो फुल लेंथ जो शुरू वाले मॉक्स होते हैं लाइक प्री सिम कैट या टेक होम्स एटसेट्रा, इन सब पे जाए। और दूसरा वो फ्रीक्वेंसी से रिलेटेड था, क्योंकि मैं सोच रहा था कि 2 दिन में एक बार दे दूं मॉक फुल लेंथ का, क्योंकि टाइम तो इश्यू है नहीं। मतलब
अच्छा, एक
सर मेरे
जॉर्डन,
को ना सेक्शन
दो मुद्दे जॉर्डन। पहली चीज, यू डायरेक्टली कॉन्ट्रडिक्टेड एवरीथिंग हैज स्टेटेड कि भाई हम पहले 10-15 सेक्शनल ले लेते हैं, लेकिन नाउ दैट यू कॉन्ट्रडिक्टेड तो अब दूसरे पे आ गए कि अब हम प्री सिमकैट ही नहीं। क्यों भाई, अगर हम नॉर्मल सिमकैट दे देंगे तो दिक्कत क्या है?
सर मैं वही मतलब सोच रहा था, जैसे जो आपने वो बिहेवियर वाले पॉइंट्स बताए थे ना, डेट सेक्शनल्स हेल्प अस टू आइडेंटिफाई। तो
भाई भाई हम बोल रहे हैं नॉर्मल मॉक देने में क्या दिक्कत है?
दिक्कत सर ऐसे ऐसे कुछ नहीं है, बस अभी वही है कि एक बार थोड़ा
देख भाई देख, अगर
टेस्ट।
दिक्कत नहीं है तो फिर अवर्शन टुवर्ड्स दैट नहीं होगा ना। दिक्कत नहीं है तो अवर्शन टुवर्ड्स टेकिंग अ फुल लेंथ मॉक नहीं होगा। पहले हम सेक्शनल देना चाहते हैं, लेकिन अगर हम सेक्शनल नहीं देना तो पहले हम प्री सिमकैट देते हैं। नॉर्मल मॉक देने में दिक्कत क्या है?
सर वो ही था जो आप बोल रहे थे कि सेक्शनल से वो आइडेंटिफाई बिहेवियर वाला जो पॉइंट है।
आई ना 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 ना, सेक्शनल इज नॉट फॉर बिहेवियर आइडेंटिफिकेशन, सेक्शनल इज फॉर बिहेवियर ट्रेनिंग आफ्टर यू टेकन मॉक्स। जो हम एरर करते हैं उसको ठीक करने के लिए सेक्शनल दे रहे हैं, सेक्शनल से बिहेवियर आइडेंटिफिकेशन तो है नहीं, बिहेवियर आइडेंटिफिकेशन मॉक्स है।
अच्छा ठीक है सर, फिर
मॉक्स नॉर्मल मॉक देना चालू करेंगे, नॉर्मल मॉक देना चालू करेंगे,
ओके
ठीक है? ओके
गॉट।
यस शुभांकर, शुभांकर चैट की जगह उसमें पूछ ले।
यस
और
हाय सर,
What all other mocks
हेलो
or what all other exams are you planning to appear for?
सर, आई एम प्लानिंग टू अपियर फॉर ओमेट्स लाइक स्नैप दैट. आई जस्ट वांटेड टू नो हाउ कैन आई मैनेज माय प्रिपरेशन, हाउ कैन वी शेड्यूल फॉर दीज, एंड व्हाट विल बी द आइडियल मॉक नंबर्स फॉर दीज एग्जाम्स,
ठीक है तो
एंड हाउ डू यू मैनेज. सर
ठीक है 25
ऑल्सो एनमैट सर.
ऑल्सो एंड बट ठीक है प्रियांश प्रियांश रुक जा आई विल सेव यू द ट्रबल। अब किसी के पास डायरेक्ट मैसेज आएगा ठीक है प्रियांश फंस गया क्योंकि उसने शुरुआत शुरुआत में हीरो हीरो बन गया बोल दिया मेरी 99% बीएआरसी में आई है। अब 15 लोग घुस गए होंगे उसके चैट में बताना भाई क्या करते बीएआरसी के लिए आए ठीक है। और स्नैप जैट एंड एनमैट इनका टाइमलाइन देखना दिस वुड स्टार्ट सम टाइम इन अक्टूबर दिस इज आफ्टर कैट दिसंबर दिसंबर एंड दिस इज फर्स्ट और सेकंड संडे ऑफ जैन मोस्ट लाइकली इट विल बी ऑन 5 जनवरी 2025 फॉर दिस साइड अक्टूबर टू पता नहीं कितने साल तक चलते ही रहते हैं मैं। नाउ सी कॉन्सेप्ट वाइज क्वांट का कॉन्सेप्ट या एलआरडीआई का कॉन्सेप्ट या अंग्रेजी का कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज रिगार्डलेस ऑफ व्हाट एग्जाम यू अपीयर फॉर। कैट में अगर वैलिड है तो एनमैट में भी वैलिड है जैट में भी वैलिड है ऐसा नहीं अरिथमेटिक के नियम कानून बदल जाते हैं दे रिमेन आइडेंटिकल सो देर इज नथिंग एक्स्ट्रा दैट यू नीड टू स्टडी इफ यू डन योर कैट प्रेप वेल देर इज नथिंग एक्स्ट्रा दैट यू नीड टू स्टडी व्हाट यू वुड हाउएवर नीड टू डू इज become familiar with the pattern. At least for snap and NMAT, you would need to become familiar with the pattern. For that, there is extra thing that you need to study called decision making. एक decision making करके एक अलग सा section आता है. And the fact that NMAT is a 3 hour plus test, इसका अलग ही लड़ाई रहता है. इसका अलग ही मेहनत रहता है. 3 hour plus test, तो इसके लिए काम करना पड़ेगा. For snap and NMAT, One of the weirdest things I see is Snap course or NMAT course or ये सब जो चीजें चल रही होती है ना मार्केट में ये बताओ कि भाई हैव द रूल्स ऑफ अरिथमेटिक चेंज्ड फ्रॉम कैट टू स्नैप और कैट टू एनमैट दे डोंट बट फिर भी स्नैप एनमैट कोर्स चल रहा होता है अंडर द गाइज ऑफ लेट्स मोनेटाइज ऑन फोमो तो चल बढ़िया चीज है ये समझ अभी कॉन्सेप्ट समझने पे ध्यान दे डू नॉट वेस्ट टाइम और एफर्ट ऑन नहीं मेरे को एनमैट की तैयारी करनी है मेरे को स्नैप की तैयारी करनी वट एवर डेट यू सेलेक्ट विद इन दिस विंडो लेट्स से 30 डेज बिफोर दैट एनमैट के लिए अगर हम अक्टूबर के महीने में देने वाले 30 डेज बिफोर दैट टेक अ मॉक योर फर्स्ट मॉक रिगार्डलेस ऑफ वट एवर टेस्ट यू अपीयर फॉर योर फर्स्ट मॉक इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी वेरी चैलेंजिंग क्योंकि एनमैट के जो फॉर्मेट रहता है क्वेश्चन You cannot skip. You have to necessarily go through every question and the question variants. कुछ 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 ऊपर नीचे रहता है non-cat reasoning के सवाल. Let's say you will have this data sufficiency questions involved or within the reasoning section there are going to be some language based things that you have to take care of. Syllogism, illogism आ जाएगा. Things that don't get touched in cat prep at all. लेकिन ये सब आ जाएगा इसमें. Once you take a mock, 30 days before the NMAT paper, whenever you schedule. Once you take a mock, First, be happy. You started earlier than most people. और कुछ काम नहीं करना है. Be happy. Then, after having gone through the solutions, looking at whatever right thing you did, wrong thing you did, take one or two mocks per week. That's it. NMAT के लिए तैयारी के नाम पे यही करना है. There is nothing extra that you need to do. I am of course assuming your theory coverage of let's say coding decoding or input output or direction sense ये सब जो NMAT non-CAT specific PILR के topics हैं जिसपे singular questions बन के आते हैं ये सब हमने theory में coverage कर रखी है उसके अलावा हमें जाके बस इसके paper pattern से familiar होना है और कुछ नहीं करना है बेसिकली टाइमिंग का आदत डालना है जैसे एनमैट के अंदर बिकॉज यू कैन नॉट स्किप ओवर अ क्वेश्चन पीपल फॉल इनटू द ट्रैप ऑफ एक क्वेश्चन उठा लिया फिर करने लगते बहुत टाइम लग गया, फिर भी अभी हम करते रहेंगे, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू आर नॉट एबल टू रीच द लास्ट क्वेश्चन इन द सेक्शन. वैसी वाली हैबिट्स ठीक करने के लिए मॉक मॉक खेलना है. सिमिलरली स्नैप का, स्नैप इज द बेस्ट टेस्ट एटलीस्ट एज इन टर्म्स ऑफ टेस्ट टेकिंग, बिकॉज इज अ 60 मिनट टेस्ट विद 60 क्वेश्चंस. बहुत ही प्यारे टेस्ट रहते हैं, सब कुछ बढ़िया रहता है. हियर राइट आफ्टर योर कैट इज डन, व्हाटएवर डे कैट इज डन, नेक्स्ट डे टेक अ मॉक अगेन. ओनली बिहेवियर रिकॉग्निशन नीड्स टू बी डन, यू डोंट नीड टू स्टडी एनीथिंग एक्स्ट्रा फॉर स्नैप. यू डोंट नीड टू, जैसे स्नैप के अंदर देर इज गोइंग टू बी मे बी डीएस, मे बी टेबल बेस्ड रीजनिंग, कुछ 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 चिंदी चिंदी सवाल रहते हैं, जो भी रहते हैं. टेक अ मॉक रिपीट एंड रिंस एंड रिपीट, यही करना है. सो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन, ये दिसंबर में 3 दिन करते हैं, 2 संडेज और 1 फ्राइडे यूजुअली पकड़ते हैं, पिछले 2-3 साल से यही आदत है. तो 2 संडेज और 1 फ्राइडे, जितने भी अटेम्प्ट आप देने वाले हैं, टेस्ट से 2 दिन पहले अपना लास्ट मॉक देके साफ कर देना. अलग से कुछ पढ़ाई करने की मेहनत में मत जाना. स्नैप डज नॉट रिक्वायर एक्स्ट्रा स्टडी. इफ यू आर अज्यूमिंग एवरीथिंग इज वेल प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर कैट, दीज एग्जाम्स डोंट रिक्वायर एडिशनल वर्क. जैट के लिए हाउएवर व्हेनेवर कैट गेट्स ओवर, 2 डेज बाद से डीएम का थोड़ा थ्योरी कवरेज करना. उसके बाद 2-3 डीएम सेक्शनल खेलना. उसके बाद सी डीएम थ्योरी कवरेज करना, 2-3 डीएम सेक्शनल खेलना, क्योंकि दिस विल अलाइन विथ योर टाइमलाइन ऑफ अब तक तुम्हारा स्नैप बैक बीत गया होगा, व्हाटएवर अटेम्प्ट्स फॉर स्नैप यू आर गोइंग टू टेक वो बीत गया होगा. इसके बाद यू गो थ्रू 4 to 5 मॉक्स हियर, दैट इज मोर देन इनफ. यहाँ पे भी यू गो थ्रू 4 to 5 मॉक्स हियर, दैट इज मोर देन इनफ. यू गो थ्रू लेट्स से 7 to 8 मॉक्स ऑफ एनमैट, दैट इज मोर देन इनफ. ऐसा नहीं है कि यहाँ पे नंबर ऑफ मॉक्स का काउंट बढ़ाने से कुछ बदल जाएगा, बिकॉज टेस्ट टेकिंग की हैबिट अपने को कैट के से ही पड़नी है. जो कैट के अंदर सीखा उसी से काम चल जाएगा. यू डोंट नीड टू स्टडी समथिंग एक्स्ट्रा और आउट ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड इन ऑर्डर टू अराइव एट मतलब प्रोफिशिएंसी इन दीज एडिशनल फॉर्मेट एग्जाम्स. ये 3 पे यही कहानी चलती है. अब लड़ाई है अगर सीमैट वीमैट और सीयूईटी पीजी इन सब पे जाएंगे अगर, तो ये सब देने वाला है क्या?
सर नहीं सर, बट एनमा जी मैट का सोच रहा हूँ सर, जी मैट एज वेल.
जीमैट, जीमैट इज अ डिफरेंट बीस्ट ऑल टुगेदर. कैट और जीमैट का देर इज वेरी लिटिल ओवरलैप, वो अलग ही गेम है. और जीमैट अगर दे
ओके
रहे हैं
okay.
तो जीमैट होपफुली अगले साल फरवरी मार्च में दे रहे हैं, बीच में तो नहीं दे रहे कभी.
नहीं सर, अभी बीच
हाँ
में
तब
रहे.
ठीक है, फिर तो कैट, तो फिर जैट खत्म होने के बाद जीमैट देंगे, तो मार्च से पहले मत देना जीमैट. और क्योंकि उसके लिए
ठीक है सर.
सेंटेंस करेक्शन की अलग पढ़ाई लगेगी, डेटा सफिशिएंसी की अलग पढ़ाई लगेगी, तो वो अलग ही बीस्ट रहेगा. यू नीड टू डेडिकेट एटलीस्ट 1 to 1.5 months ऑफ थ्योरी कवरेज, उसके बाद एटलीस्ट 7 to 8 मॉक्स ऑफ जीमैट एज वेल, तब जाके हम एक्चुअल जीमैट देने की गुड सिचुएशन में आएंगे. डोंट ट्राई टू फिट इन जीमैट इन बिटवीन कैट प्रेप समवेयर.
सर आई जस्ट हैव अ क्वेश्चन. एसपी जेन जो जीमैट के स्कोर्स लेता है
वो
तो
डिसंबर
फेब
एंड तक वाले
ओके
स्कोर लेता है.
दैट इज बेटर. ओके
एनीथिंग एल्स पीपल, एनीथिंग एल्स? इफ नॉट श्रेयांश.
हाय सर. सो मेरा ये क्वेश्चन था कि अभी सर थियोरी कवरेज चल रहा है, लाइव क्लासेस तो अटेंड नहीं कर पा रहा हूँ बिकॉज ऑफ वर्क टाइमिंग्स, तो कभी कभी रिकॉर्डिंग्स, कभी थोड़ा प्रैक्टिस यहाँ वहाँ पे. सो आई फील कि सर मेरा थोड़ा टाइम लगेगा थियोरी कवरेज होने में, बट आई डोंट थिंक आई बी एबल स्टार्ट मॉक्स बाय अगस्त और सितंबर.
ओके देन व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन?
सर या तो मैं प्रैक्टिस करूँ या तो मैं मॉक्स लूँ, उनमें से आई थिंक आई कैन डू ओनली वन थिंग.
तो अच्छा, आइदर यू कैन गेट अ गुड परसेंटाइल और यू कैन गेट अ बैड परसेंटाइल. यू कैन ऑल्सो गेट वन ऑफ दोज टू थिंग्स ऑल्सो. तो फिर क्या लेंगे?
sir, of course, the good one, but I
but
get
then
your point, sir.
but then that requires both both the parts of the matrix. No, ये नहीं कर सकते ना कि एक काम करेंगे दूसरा काम नहीं करेंगे. See,
So has
the entire point is, see, you're working, that is a constraint, yes, but outside of that, are we dedicating all our free time to CAT prep?
Most of the time, yes. Mostly, yes.
Like, you don't have to answer to me. You need to answer it to yourself. If you are dedicating most of your time to CAT prep, then that is the best you can do. Then there is no resolution around it. Then we will do what we can do. We will cut down on our practice target numbers. ये सब things that you should be cutting down on. और फिर हम ज़्यादा mock walk दे लेंगे. If it works out well, so great. If it doesn't work out well, we are prepared for that eventuality. We cannot be expecting कि अब my effort will be limited, but नहीं मेरे को success guaranteed चाहिए. That cannot happen. But maybe the effort we put in this cycle helps us in the next cycle. लेकिन ये मतलब it is a constraint. At the same time, don't be too क्या बताएं स्पेंड ऑन द आइडिया कि अगर नहीं सक्सीड किया तो अटर फेलियर है. समटाइम्स नॉट सक्सीडिंग इज ऑन द पाथ टू सक्सेस. अगले साल में काम चल जाएगा. ये सब जो हम टारगेट्स बताते थे, अंडरस्टैंड ऑल ऑफ दीज आर ओपिनियंस, देयर इज नो साइंस बिहाइंड इट. ऑल ऑफ दीज आर ओपिनियंस एंड देर आर पीपल हु डोंट फॉलो एवरीथिंग दैट आई से. देर आर डिफरेंट पीपल हु डू डिफरेंट सॉर्ट्स ऑफ थिंग्स. मे बी यू ओनली टेक मॉक्स एंड यू एंड अप सिक्योरिंग अ वेरी वेरी गुड परसेंटाइल. That in no way is going to change my opinion for the next cycle, and that in no way is going to mean ki bhai aisa karne se ho jata hai waisa karne se ho jata hai. Maybe you are intelligent beforehand, maybe you need a lot more practice. Dono ka idea nahi. Abhi apne paas ek constraint hai ki because we are working, because of the work times that we have lesser time available, so we are not able to dedicate enough time to both things, practice and mocks. We adjust, we perhaps bring down our mock count to 15 and we do our minimum required practice number to 100, wherever it was 200 or 50, wherever it was 100. वैसा कुछ adjustment करेंगे बस वही कर सकते हैं और कुछ है नहीं ना रास्ता. Yes, बन्नी.
ठीक है sir, thank you.
Yeah, hello. Oh, good evening sir.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, yes, go on.
Sir, am I clear? Am I
yes.
audible?
You are audible, you are clear, everything is
sir,
good.
So, yes, sir. So, my DILR section is going worst pace right now. So, if I can go through those 400 plus sets in aptitude job or 200 plus sets in anesthesis, which are available on YouTube, can I be able to reach that saturation point where I can solve two sets at least in the mock test or in the actual CAT exam?
So when did you start preparation, Bunny?
Sir, I just started in the June. I was just going through the syllabus now. But I feel like whatever I'm...
You started in June. So far, it's been 1 month, 20 odd days. How many sets have we practiced so far?
Yes.
What is our level of theory coverage?
Sir, I just have practiced around 120 sets. That's
how
like
have you practiced 120 sets?
More.
Your theory coverage is done and you've practiced 120 sets in this timeline. Either you're a genius or you're not doing practice. You're simply watching videos there.
No,
sir. इतनी जल्दी में तो हम नहीं कर पाएंगे.
Yes, sir. I'm simply watching videos.
Then it is absolutely useless. Then you do aptitude,
no, sir,
jab,
no,
elites,
did
every video on YouTube you watch, it will be useless then. देख पहली चीज मेक श्योर योर थ्योरी कवरेज इज डन. योर थ्योरी कवरेज गेम्स एंड टूर्नामेंट बेसिक्स,
व्हाट शुड आई हैव टू डू,
योर गेम्स एंड टूर्नामेंट बेसिक्स, योर अरेंजमेंट बेसिक्स, योर कैलकुलेशन थिंग्स दैट वन नीड्स टू बी गुड एट एंड लायर पजल्स, व्हाट ऑल आइडियाज आर देयर, द वेन डायग्राम्स बेस्ड रिकॉर्डिंग, फोर सेट वेन डायग्राम्स, थ्री सेट वेन डायग्राम्स, एवरीथिंग बट समथिंग दिस नॉट दैट, conditional statements, all these topics you need to do the theory coverage of. After that, when you get to practice means you look at that set, the set that is present in the video, you pause the video, you solve it yourself, you give yourself 30 to 40 minutes to solve it. If you can solve it earlier than that, great. Even if you're not able to solve it, still spend some 30 to 40 minutes on that set. If you are still unable to solve it, you start the video, you see the initial recording, then you pause the video again. You try to solve it yourself now. If you are now able to reach the answer, great. If you are not able to reach the answer, then watch the full video. This is not Netflix that if you watch a video, somehow information will seep through to you. And isme ye samajh, you can, I can watch thousands of movies on Netflix. Thousands of movies. Achha, I don't have Netflix. I can watch thousands of movies on Amazon Prime. Will that make me a good movie director?
Okay.
Unless I make movies, unless I get into the habit of looking at angles and casting people in certain roles and giving them what telling them what emotions needs to be used at the time of speaking those lines, I am not learning any skill. Watching a video is not preparation at all, which is what 120 sets by now is too high, which is a clear indication. अभी हमने अपनी पढ़ाई कम करी है. अच्छा, इसमें दुखी मत हो. इसमें हालत ये है कि we are preparing for the first time MGC. Are we preparing for CAT for the first time?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है. दुखी मत हो भाई, दुखी मत हो. बस ये समझ,
yes, sir.
अभी अपना अपना जो प्रोसेस अपना प्रोसेस जो चल रहा है वो अभी थोड़ा कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड है. एंड आई एम गेसिंग यू आर टेकिंग अ लॉट ऑफ क्या बताएं इनपुट फ्रॉम पब्लिक फोरम्स. बस यूट्यूब पे ये सेट्स कवर करने, वहां पे वो सेट्स कवर करने,
yes,
होता, खुद से सॉल्व करने की बात करते हैं. यू आर सपोज टू अटेम्प्ट दैट सेट योरसेल्फ. जस्ट वॉचिंग अ वीडियो इज नॉट इनफ. एंड बिफोर अटेम्प्टिंग दो सेट्स हमें थोड़ा बहुत थ्योरी कवरेज करना पड़ेगा. इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ दैट, यही समझना, इवन इफ आई वॉच 1000 वीडियोस ऑन लेट्स से न्यूक्लियर फिजन एंड फ्यूजन राइट नाउ, डज दैट इन सम वे क्वालिफाई मी टू बिकम एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ न्यूक्लियर साइंटिस्ट वाली हालत नहीं आएगी ना मेरी, क्योंकि मेरे को वो रिसर्च खुद से करना पड़ेगा, खुद एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन करना पड़ेगा फॉर मी टू हैव सम अथॉरिटी ऑन दैट इश्यू. सिंपली वॉचिंग अ वीडियो, वो अभी ये जो 120 वीडियोस देखे भी है, फॉर दीज 120 वीडियोस इफ आई वर टू रैंडमली पिक अप अ वीडियो एंड गिव यू दैट सेट, वुड यू बी एबल टू सॉल्व?
नॉट मोस्ट प्रोबब्ली, नो सर,
नॉट रियली. तो फिर अभी हमने वो सेट, दो सेट्स हैव, मतलब वी हैव सम फैमिलियरिटी विद देम, वी डोंट नो दो सेट्स. अभी पहले थ्योरी कवरेज करेंगे, फिर वो प्रैक्टिस वाला वीडियो कवरेज रहता है, सिर्फ वीडियो देखने की बात नहीं रहती है. जुलाई में चालू किया कैट की तैयारी, जून में चालू किया कैट की तैयारी, ठीक है, हमने तैयारी लेट से चालू किया. देन दो, तो फर्स्ट थिंग Regardless of the timeline that you have, the steps are the steps. पहले हमें थ्योरी कवरेज करनी पड़ेगी, उसके बाद हमें प्रैक्टिस करना पड़ेगा, उसके बाद हमें मॉकिंग करनी पड़ेगी. The steps remain the same. If we can perhaps do it at a faster pace, it would be great. If we cannot do it at a faster pace, this year's effort will perhaps bear fruit in the next cycle. But the effort remains the same. The steps remain the same. ऐसा नहीं है कि अगर if there existed a way, जो ना अगर हम जनवरी से पढ़ा रहे कैट के लिए और इफ देयर एग्जिस्टेड अ वे जो 3 महीने में वो जनवरी से वाला सारा काम करा सकते, हम जुलाई से ही पढ़ाते, हम क्यों जनवरी से पढ़ा रहे होते? उतनी मेहनत करता कौन? 3 महीने का मस्त काम चला रहे होते. विच इज वाई आई होल्ली एंड सोल्ली अगेंस्ट क्रैश कोर्सेज, आई एम होल्ली एंड सोल्ली अगेंस्ट स्पेसिफिक आइडियाज. क्योंकि भाई जब 9 महीने के अंदर आप कोर्स बेच रहे हो और 3 महीने के अंदर कोर्स भी आप बेच रहे, 3 महीने में अगर आप पढ़ा सकते हो, 9 महीने का काम चल गया. योर स्टेप्स विल रिमेन प्रिसाइसली द सेम. यू विल हैव टू डू थ्योरी कवरेज, यू विल हैव टू डू प्रैक्टिस, यू विल हैव टू डू मॉक टेस्ट टेकिंग. इफ यू कैन डू इट एट अ फास्टर पेस, ग्रेट. बट देन इफ यू कांट डू इट एट अ फास्टर पेस, डोंट बी सैडेड. बेसिकली यू आर सेटिंग, यू आर फ्रेमिंग द क्वेश्चन दिस वे, कैट नवंबर में तो हम कैसे खत्म करें? विदाउट टेकिंग इनटू अकाउंट कैट नवंबर में होने से पहले देयर वर सर्टेन डिसीजंस दैट यू हैड टेकन, यू हैव टू टेक लेट्स से अकाउंटेबिलिटी फॉर दैट इज, इसके बाद आगे का काम होगा ना. तो अभी अपनी मेहनत करेंगे, अभी पहले थ्योरी कवरेज करेंगे. फर्स्ट स्टेप फॉर यू शुड बी थ्योरी कवरेज, नो क्वेश्चंस आस्क्ड.
ओके सर.
दैट विल बी ऑल. एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस पीपल?
या थैंक्स सो मच सर.
Go home, sleep, have fun. Okay, bye. See you. Makes sense. Okay.